Welcome back. Mary Butler, you mentioned fetal abnormality before the break, and you have a personal situation that I think, would it be fair to say, informs your beliefs in this whole area.
Well, I would agree with you there. I did mention fetal abnormalities because I suppose maybe up to 5 or 6 years ago we weren't used to that term. And I have a little cousin myself. She's 15. She has CDLS syndrome, which is Amsterdam dwarfism. As I said, she's 15 years of age. She has never spoken. She has never walked. She's a joy to behold. She's tube fed every day. She has the love of her mother, her father, and her brother, and her extended family. And why should she be denied the right to live? And that's why I feel very, very strongly about this. I also feel the right to life of the unborn needs to be recognised within the Constitution as it is at the moment. And I feel like, why should her life be worth any less than my children or anyone else here on the panel's children? And I think, you know, I'm very, very concerned after the weekend listening to the whole debate around Down syndrome and the fact that there, since this new screening has been introduced, that in Iceland, for example, no child with Down syndrome has been born within the last 4 years. And in Denmark, for example, there's only been a handful of children born with Down syndrome.
Yeah, if such a scenario were to apply here, it would have to have been done so by legislation, irrespective of whether or not...
my fear is that if abortion was introduced into this country and we would have abortion on demand, like, where does it end?
Is your position, Mary, that if there was a referendum, it would be the beginning of the so-called, as it's described in some places, the slippery slope?
I do.
Right.
So I do.